So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. And guys, in today's session I will bring to you the summary for the month of May 2021. So a lot of students guys were asking about the weekly revisions or the monthly revision. So I have decided that I will bring to you monthly revisions. Okay, hum monthly revisions kara karenge. And this we will do in the form of questions. Okay, so this will also act like a quiz for you guys, right? And these are the best questions from the month of May 2021, which have the high chances of being asked in your exam. So let's begin with the session, guys. But before we begin, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon if you are coming here for the first time. And ताकि आपको videos की latest notification मिल सके. Okay. So let's begin with the very first question. And remember, आप सभी को answer करना है. And at the end of the session, you have to tell me your marks also. Okay. So there are total 33 questions. And out of 33 questions, आपको अपने marks comment में लिख के बताने. So question number one is, which country was the biggest spender of global military expenditure in the year 2020 according to SIPRI? So guys, if you remember, Stockholm International Peace Research Institute has released a report on global military expenditure for the year 2020. And according to this report, the top five spenders of the military expenditures in the year 2020 were USA, China, India, Russia and United Kingdom. So these are the top five expenditures in the military area. Okay, the fifth one is United Kingdom. And remember, these five countries accounted for 62% of the total global military expenditure. Jo pure duniya mein military expenditure hua tha, uska 62% in 5 countries ne hi kiya tha. And USA spent $778 billion. $778 billion, a huge amount, while India spent $72.9 billion on military. Okay, so this is about this news and I hope you can easily answer this question now. The biggest spender was USA, option C will be the correct answer. And top 5 ko naam aapko yaad rakhna hai, you should remember the name of top 5, which are USA, China, India, Russia and United Kingdom. And now let's move ahead to question number 2. How much additional amount will be provided to states under the scheme of financial assistance to states for capital expenditure for spending on capital projects for the financial year 2021-22? So this scheme was launched in last year in the previous financial year, and in the previous financial year 12,000 crores were allocated for this scheme. Now for this financial year, rupees 15,000 crores have been allocated. 15,000 crore rupees allocate kiya gaya hai. And this scheme guys is providing financial assistance to the states for spending on capital projects. कैपिटल प्रोजेक्ट्स पे खर्चा करने के लिए पैसे दिए जाते हैं स्टेट्स को. एंड रिमेंबर, आउट ऑफ दिस 15,000 करोड़, दिस 15,000 करोड़ इज डिवाइडेड इनटू 3 पार्ट्स. पार्ट 1 इज 2600 करोड़, पार्ट 2 इज 7400 करोड़, एंड पार्ट 3 इज 5,000 करोड़. ओके, एंड दिस 2600 करोड़ विल बी गिवन अंडर पार्ट 1 टू द नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न स्टेट्स एंड द हिली स्टेट्स. 7400 करोड़ विल बी गिवन टू दो स्टेट्स विच आर नॉट कवर्ड अंडर दिस पार्ट 1, वाइल दिस 5,000 करोड़ विल बी गिवन फॉर मोनेटाइजेशन. It will be given for monetization of infrastructure assets and also for the disinvestment of state public sector enterprises. Okay, so here the correct answer is what, option B, 15,000 crores. Question number 3 says, to improve the lives and livelihoods of the tribal people, TRIFED has entered into a memorandum of understanding with the Link Fund, which is based in. So this Link Fund, ye Link Fund kahan pe hai, ye organization kahan pe based hai, aapko ye batana hai. And this, remember guys, this MOU has been signed under a project which is known as Sustainable Livelihood for Tribal Households in India. Sustainable Livelihoods for Tribal Households in India is the name of the project. And this MOU has been signed with Link Fund, which is a Geneva based organization. So option C, Geneva, Switzerland will be the correct answer. Question number 4 says, and remember, some questions are same and kuch questions ko maine change kar diya hai. Kuch questions bilkul same copy kiye hain jo ki humne pehle padhe the. To basic jo hamara objective hai wo hai revise karna, to wo un questions ke through bhi kiya ja sakta hai, but bahut sare questions maine isme change bhi kar diye hain, to almost 50-50% ka ratio hai. So you have to consider the following statements regarding network for greening the financial system and you have to select the correct statement. So this network guys was in news because recently RBI has joined this network for greening the financial system. And remember, this is a network of central banks and supervisors. And ye un sab logo ka group hai, which are willing to share their best practices ऑन द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एनवायरमेंट, एनवायरमेंट को डेवलप करने के लिए इन द फाइनेंस सेक्टर. ओके, सो दिस इज अ नेटवर्क बेसिकली ऑफ लाइक माइंडेड पीपल ऑफ सेंट्रल बैंक एंड सुपरवाइजर्स ऑफ डिफरेंट कंट्रीज, ऑफ डिफरेंट कंट्रीज सेंट्रल बैंक. ओके, और वो लोग मिलके क्या करते हैं, बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस शेयर करते हैं ताकि एनवायरमेंट का डेवलप किया जा सके थ्रू द फाइनेंशियल, थ्रू द फाइनेंस सेक्टर. ओके, एंड इट वॉज, रिमेंबर इट वॉज लॉन्च एट द वन प्लैनेट समिट इन द ईयर 2017 इन द मंथ ऑफ डिसंबर, एंड इट इज इट्स हेडक्वार्टर इज इट्स इन फैक्ट इट्स सेक्रेटेरियट इज होस्टेड बाय बैंक ऑफ फ्रांस. ओके, इसका जो सेक्रेटेरियट है वो कौन होस्ट कर रहा है, बैंक ऑफ फ्रांस. ओके, सो यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट हियर. RBI has joined the central banks and supervisors NGFS as a member. This is absolutely correct. NGFS was launched at the Paris One Planet Summit. This is correct. And its secretariat is hosted by Bank of France. So all the statements are absolutely correct here. Therefore, the correct answer will be, guys, option E, all are correct. Question number 5. Which model has been applied by scientists of IIT Kanpur and Hyderabad to predict the COVID graph in India? सो ये एक मॉडल अप्लाई किया था आईटी कानपुर और हैदराबाद के साइंटिस्ट ने ताकि जो कोविड का ग्राफ है उसको प्रेडिक्ट किया जा सके. एंड रिमेंबर द मॉडल, द नेम ऑफ द मॉडल इज सूत्रा, एंड सूत्रा ऑफ कोर्स हैज अ फुल फॉर्म आल्सो व्हिच इज ससेप्टिबल अनडिटेक्टेड टेस्टेड एंड रिमूव्ड अप्रोच. सो यू शुड रिमेंबर द फुल फॉर्म ऑल्सो. Okay, susceptible, undetected, tested and removed approach. And remember, there are three parameters in this model. Number one is beta, number two is reach, and number three is epsilon. Now, beta measures how many person an infected person can infect in a day. Reach measures the, kitni population jo hai, wo pandemic se expose ho gayi hai, the exposure of the population to the pandemic. And epsilon is the ratio of infected and the non-infected people. Okay. Question number 6. Which of the following is correct regarding the base year under the production linked incentive scheme for food processing industry? So the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare has approved the PLI scheme for food processing industry. And remember, this is for a duration starting from financial year 2022 to the financial year 2027, which means for a period of 6 years. Okay, and isme the total financial outlay is how much? 10,900 crores. 10,900 crore ka total financial outlay hai. And there are four categories of foods that will be provided incentives, which are ready to cook or ready to eat food. Number two is the processed fruits and vegetables. Number three is the marine products, and number four is the mozzarella cheese. Okay, so these are the four categories of products that will be provided incentives under the scheme. And remember, the incentives will be provided on the incremental sales over the base year. And for the first 4 years, the base year will be 2019-20. For the fifth year, it will be 2021-22. While for the sixth year, it will be 2022-23. Okay. And here the question is about the base year. So let's read out the statement. 2019-20 for the first 4 years. This is absolutely correct. 2021-22 for the fifth and sixth year. No. 21-22 is only for the 5th year, while for the 6th year it is 22-23. And 2019-20, ये तो गलती है भाई. तो एक पहला ही स्टेटमेंट करेक्ट है. सो ऑप्शन ए, ओनली वन विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन 7. विद विच कंट्री इंडिया हैज साइंड एन एमओयू फॉर ग्लोबल इनोवेशन पार्टनरशिप अंडर विच एन ई मार्केट प्लेस नेम्ड एज ई बाजार विल बी ओपन फॉर क्रॉस बॉर्डर ट्रांसफर ऑफ इनोवेशन. एक ई बाजार नाम का ई मार्केट प्लेस ओपन किया जाएगा अंडर दिस एमओयू. And also under this MOU, the Indian entrepreneurs and innovators will be provided with the seed funding. They will also provided with the technical assistance from the companies based in UK. So the correct answer is option B, UK. This MOU has been signed with UK. And question number 8 ki baat kar lete hain. Which section of the Social Security Code 2020 has been notified by the Ministry of Labour and Employment, which covers applicability of Aadhaar? Now you have to tell me who is the Minister of Labour and Employment. Write down in the comments. And this section, guys, remember, is section 142, which now will deal with the applicability of Aadhaar. And this has been done to collect the Aadhaar data of the migrant workers so that the welfare schemes ka benefit can be provided to them. And also there is a national database of unorganized worker which is under construction. National database of unorganized workers is under construction by the Ministry of Labour and Employment, and you have to tell me who is the Minister of Labour and Employment. Question number 9. Recently, a new concept, Model Insurance Village, has been developed in the insurance sector to give a boost to the penetration of insurance in the rural areas. Question is, which organization has developed this concept? Now remember, Model Insurance Village ka jo idea hai, what is the idea behind Model Insurance Village? So remember, if there is a village which is a Model Insurance Village, then in that village insurance will be provided, all the possible insurance will be provided to all, against all the insurable risk to all the people there. Okay, jitne bhi wahan pe villagers hain, unko insurance provide karaya jayega against all the insurable risk that can be provided. Okay, and remember, for the first year there is a target to provide, to develop 500 Model Insurance Villages in the first year, while after the second year the target is how much? 1000 Model Insurance Villages will be developed in 2 years, and this has been coined by IRDAI. Option D, IRDAI is the correct answer, which is headquartered in Hyderabad, and Subhash Chandra Khuntia is the chairperson of IRDAI. Question number 10. Consider the following statements regarding data released by OECD with respect to the global FDI, and you have to identify the correct statement. Very, very important question. So this data has been released by OECD. Remember, OECD is headquartered in Paris, which is also the headquarter of Reporters Without Borders, and also it is the headquarter for UNESCO. And remember, Reporters Without Borders, ek bahut important report release karti hai har saal. Can you tell me the name of that report that is being released by Reporters Without Borders every year? Write down in the comments. So you have to identify the correct statement. Let's talk about this report, guys. So this report says that the global FDI was dropped by 38% to $846 billion. $846 billion tak pahunch gaya hai, and there is a drop of 38%. And the top 3 receiver of FDI in the year 2020 were China, USA and India. Number 1 paid was China, number 2 paid USA, number 3 paid was India. And this report also says that the largest FDI outflow was from Luxembourg se tha, and also this report says that the FDI inflow for the G20 countries dropped by 28% ho gaya hai unka drop, kinka? G20 countries ka. So let's talk about these statements. The global FDI inflow has been dropped by 38% in 2020. Absolutely correct, and it has been dropped to $88.46 billion. USA was the largest receiver of FDI. No, it was China. USA was at number 2. And India stood at 3rd position in the list of FDI recipients in the year 2020. This is absolutely correct. And here we have to identify the correct statement, which means option A. Only 2 and 3, guys, will be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 11. Government of India and European Investment Bank have signed the finance contract for second tranche of €150 million for Pune Metro Rail project. The question is, what is the total corpus that had been approved by EIB? So can you answer this question? Yes, you are absolutely right. The correct answer is what? €600 million, option A, will be the correct answer. The total corpus is €600 million, and out of this, €150 million recently provided karaya hai European Investment Bank ne. Question number 12, which is a very easy question. Which state under its annual action plan of Jal Jeevan Mission has targeted to provide 30 lakh new connections till 2021-22, which means in this financial year, this should be in. In 2021-22, this state has targeted that they will provide 30 lakh new connections, new tap connections, in fact, under the Jal Jeevan Mission. And Jal Jeevan Mission has the target to provide 100% tap connections to all the rural households in our country by the year 2020. It is also known as Har Ghar Jal project. And remember, this state provided 4 lakh connections in the previous financial year of 2020-21, and this state, guys, is Kerala. Option C, Kerala, is the correct answer. Now you have to tell me the chief minister of Kerala. Write down in the comments, who is the chief minister of Kerala? Question number 13. So abhi tak 3 question aapke liye ho chuke hain, to aapko teenon question ka jawab bhi dena, aur at the end of the session you have to tell me your marks also. Consider the following statements regarding 3rd Arctic Science Ministerial, and you have to identify the incorrect statement. So this was the 3rd edition of Arctic Science Ministerial, and before this the 2 editions were held in USA in the year 2016 and in Germany. The 2nd edition was in Germany in the year 2018. and this edition, the third edition, was organized by Japan and Iceland. It was organized by Japan and Iceland, and remember, the theme was Knowledge for a Sustainable Arctic, and this was organized to enhance the knowledge of the stakeholders which are working towards the which are working in the research of the Arctic region. Okay, and Dr. Harshvardhan also participated from India side. India ki taraf se kaun the? Dr. Harshvardhan the. And remember some facts about India and Arctic region. So India is the observer. India is the observer in the Arctic Council. India jo hai observer hai Arctic Council mein. And also we have a permanent research station which is known as Himadri. Himadri in this region. And we also have one more thing in this region which is known as INDARC. And INDARC basically it is an observatory. It is an observatory. It is basically a multi-sensor observatory in dark. Okay. And we have to identify the incorrect statement. Alright. So Japan and China nahi hai. These two are absolutely correct. 2 and 3. So we have to identify the incorrect statement, which means option E, only one will be the correct answer, because it is the only statement which is incorrect here. Question number 14. Consider the following statements regarding mission for integrated horticulture development, and you have to identify the correct statements. So it was in news because recently the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare has approved rupees 2250 crores for the financial year 2021-22 for this scheme. And remember, this scheme is under implementation since 2014-15, or you can say the financial year 2015. And the objective of this scheme is to realize the potential of horticulture crops like fruits, vegetables, etc. And since its implementation, the area under the horticulture crops has been increased by 9%, while the production under of the horticultural crops has been increased by 14%. Now let's read out the statement, and you have to identify the correct statement. The mission is under implementation since 2012-13. No, it is under implementation since 2014-15. For 21-22, the fund allocated is 5200 crores. No. And the mission has resulted in increase in area under horticulture by 14%. No, this is 9%, while the production has been increased by 14%. Okay. So none is correct. Option D will be the correct answer. Question number 15. Which of the following banks has organized a virtual seminar, social infrastructure financing and use of digital technologies in collaboration with the Department of Economic Affairs? This can be asked in your one marker. This is important question because it is directly related with the Department of Economic Affairs. And this bank, guys, is New Development Bank. Option B is the correct answer. New Development Bank is headquartered in Shanghai, which is, of course, in China. And Marcos Prado Troyjo is the president of NDB. And he's from Brazil. And NDB, guys, is also known as BRICS Bank. Isko BRICS Bank bhi kaha jata hai. Question number 16. Recently, IREDA has been conferred with Green Urja Award to excel in green financing. By which organization this award has been conferred to IREDA? So this award has been given to IREDA for providing largest number of finance in the green financing. Green financing mein sabse zyada fund provide karane ke liye this award has been given. Now, what is the meaning of green financing? So green financing means the financing of the projects which are related to the energy, which are related to the renewable energy, is known as green financing. Okay. So, or in the year 2021, which means the previous financial year, IREDA had provided ₹8827 crores as the green financing, which is the largest in our country. And this award has been conferred by ICC, Indian Chamber of Commerce. And IREDA, remember guys, it is a mini Ratna under the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. It was established in the year 1987. And current CMD is Mr. Pradeep Kumar Das, who was there to receive this award. Pradeep Kumar Das ne award received kiya tha jaake. Okay, and he's the CMD. Question number 17. Consider the following statements regarding the PLI scheme, National Program on Advanced Chemistry Cell Battery Storage, and you have to identify the correct statement. So this statement, this scheme, PLI scheme, National Program on Advanced Chemistry Cell Battery Storage, has been approved by the Government of India, and it has the objective to develop the manufacturing capacity of 50 gigawatt hour of ACC, which means Advanced Chemistry Cell Battery Storage. And the total outlay of this scheme is 18,100 crores. And remember, each beneficiary under this scheme has to ensure a minimum 60% of domestic value addition at the project level. And also, it is expected that there will be an import substitution of around 20,000 crore every year. So this third statement is correct, and we have to identify the correct statement here. Each beneficiary has to ensure 60. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And the total outlay for the scheme is not 20,000 crore, it's 18,100 crores. So 2 and 3 are correct, which means option B, only 2 and 3 guys, will be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 18. You have to consider the following statements regarding special window for affordable and mid-income housing fund, which in short is SWAMIH fund. And you have to identify the incorrect statement. Now let's talk about this SWAMIH fund. So remember, the SWAMIH fund was announced in the year 2019 as an alternative investment fund. Alternative investment fund for providing funding to the affordable and middle income housing projects. Okay, affordable and middle income housing projects ko funding dene ke liye this SWAMIH fund was announced. And in its initial purpose, remember, was 25,000 crores. And out of this 25,000 crore, 10,000 crore was given by central government, while rest 15,000 crore was from SBI and LIC. SBI and LIC. Which brings me to its fund manager. Its fund manager is what? SBI Cap Ventures Limited. SBI Cap Ventures Limited is the is the fund manager of this SWAMIH fund. And इसमें क्या होता है, जो escrow account से उसके अंदर पैसा डाला जाता है, which can be used for the required purpose only. So now let's talk about the statements. Incorrect statements identify करने हैं. It was announced in 2015. No, it was in 2019 that it was announced. Its initial corpus was rupees 50,000 crores. No, it was 25,000 crores. And it is an alternative investment fund. This is absolutely correct. So first and second statements are incorrect. Option A will be the correct answer. Question number 19 is about the Inclusive Internet Index, and you have to identify the correct statement. So let's talk about this index, Inclusive Internet Index. Inclusive Internet Index, guys, was released by Economist Intelligence Unit, which is headquartered in London, which is based in London. And remember, this index ranks the countries on the basis of internet availability, relevance of internet, and readiness of people to use it. Okay, readiness of people to use it. So ye char cheezon pe char parameters ke upar ye index jo hai wo countries ko rank karta hai. And remember, the top three countries in fact were Sweden, USA and Spain, and India was at rank 49th. Alright, so now let's talk about these statements. The top three countries are USA, Japan and France. No, it was Sweden, USA and Spain. The report has been released by World Economic Forum in association with Facebook. It's not World Economic Forum, it's Economist Intelligence Unit, and yes, they have released this report in association with Facebook. And the report is based on 5 parameters. So none of the statements are correct. Option D, none is correct, will be the correct answer. And now let's talk about question number 2. Consider the following statements regarding the world economic situation and prospects, mid-year report of United Nations, and you have to identify the correct statements regarding this. So this report, guys, talks about the GDP growth of India, GDP growth of world, for the calendar year 2021 and the calendar year 2022. And it also talks about some other regions like South Asian region and overall Asia. So itna sara detail mein hame padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. Is report ne ye bola that India's GDP will grow to 7.5%. India's GDP growth will be 7.5% in the calendar year 2021. While for the calendar year 2022, the GDP growth will be 10.1%. And India will be the fastest growing economy, okay, in the year 2022. And the report also says that the global GDP will expand by 5.4% in the year 2021. Okay, so correct statement identify karna aapko. The report forecasted India's GDP growth to 7.5%. yes, this is absolutely correct. And remember, in the January World Economic Situation and Prospect, the United Nations forecasted GDP growth 7.3%. okay, but now they have increased it by 0.2%, and currently the forecasting is how much? 7.5%. The global economy is projected to expand by 5.4%, absolutely correct, in 2022 India will be fastest growing major economy of the world with GDP growth of 10.1%. So all the statements are correct. Option E will be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 2. With which of the following companies, Ministry of Tribal Affairs has signed an MOU and joint initiative for digital transformation of tribal schools? So all the tribal schools, like we have Eklavya model, residential schools, we have ashram schools. So all the schools which comes under the ambit of Ministry of Tribal Affairs, उन सभी का डिजिटल ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन करा जाएगा. एंड फॉर दिस द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स हैज साइंड एन एमओयू विद माइक्रोसॉफ्ट. ऑप्शन बी माइक्रोसॉफ्ट इज द करेक्ट आंसर. नेम द टेली काउंसलिंग सर्विसेज प्रोवाइड बाय नेशनल कमीशन फॉर प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ चाइल्ड राइट्स फॉर साइकोसोशल साइकोलॉजिकल सपोर्ट टू चिल्ड्रन ड्यूरिंग कोविड-19. कोविड-19 के समय साइकोलॉजिकल सपोर्ट प्रोवाइड कराने के लिए देर इज अ टेली काउंसलिंग सर्विस दैट इज बींग प्रोवाइडेड बाय नेशनल कमीशन फॉर प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ चाइल्ड राइट्स. Now you have to tell the name of that particular telecounseling services. And the correct answer to this question is Samvedna. Now remember, Samvedna has a full form also. Sensitizing action on mental health vulnerability. Sensitizing action on mental health vulnerability through emotional development and necessary acceptance. So this is a very long full form. But yes, आपको ये याद रखने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. Just ये मेरे को याद हो गया तो मैंने आपको बता दिया. इट्स फुल फॉर्म इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द एग्जाम. ओके, सो ऑप्शन ए संवेदना इज द करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 23. कम्युनिटी बेस्ड इंक्लूसिव डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम ऑन रिहैबिलिटेशन ऑफ दिव्यांगजन हैज बीन को डिजाइंड बाय रिहैबिलिटेशन काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया एंड यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ डैश. सो रिमेंबर गाइज, दिस यूनिवर्सिटी इज यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ मेलबर्न, ऑप्शन बी ऑस्ट्रेलिया. एंड under this project what will happen that the Rehabilitation Council of India and University of Melbourne, they will develop trained persons for rehabilitation and development of the divyangjans, or you can say the person with disabilities. So the correct answer is what, option B, Melbourne, Australia. Question number 24. Which state or UT government has launched Medicine from the Sky project to deliver medicines and vaccines with drones? Remember this, through this Medicine from the Sky project, the medicines and vaccine will be delivered with the help of drones. And for this, the permission has been granted under the unmanned aircraft system rules. Aircraft systems rules 2021. And this rules, guys, deals with the usage of drones. Okay. And this state, guys, is Telangana. Option E, Telangana, is the correct answer. And also, the Telangana government has collaborated with the World Economic Forum and HealthNet Global. HealthNet Global is a private company. So, in dono ke saath collaboration kiya hai Telangana ne for the implementation of this Medicine from the Sky project. Question number 25. Shri Narendra Singh Tomar has launched NMMS, which is National Mobile Monitoring Software app, and Area Officer Monitoring app. These two apps have been launched. For which scheme NMMS has been launched? And we all know Shri Narendra Singh Tomar is the Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. He is also the Ministry of Panchayati Raj and rural development, and he is currently also the Minister of food processing industry ke bhi ye minister hai. Okay, so kaun si scheme ke liye NMMS launch kiya gaya? So remember, it has been launched for Manrega, and this app is for marking the attendance of the workers which are working at the Manrega sites, and also for the geotagged photographs of the works which is under construction. Okay, so here the correct answer is what, option A, Manrega. Question number 26. How much subsistence allowance is being given to the transgender person in view of COVID-19 by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment? And it is headed by Mr. Thawar Chand Gehlot, and he is also the leader in Rajya Sabha. And this subsistence allowance, or the one-time allowance, is how much? ₹1500 ka subsistence allowance diya jayega to the transgender person for meeting their basic needs during these hard times of COVID. Question 27. The ICMR approved the India's first self-use rapid antigen test for COVID-19, which is named as CoviSelf. The question is, which organization has developed this kit? This is very, very important question, and इसमें यही question आ सकता है, इसके अलावा कोई question नहीं आएगा. या ज्यादा से ज्यादा question ये और आ सकता है कि what is the name of the India's first self-use rapid antigen test kit for COVID-19, which has been developed by MyLab Discovery Solutions. So in that case, the answer would be CoviSelf. Okay, but here the answer is what, option C, MyLab Discovery Solutions. Question number 28 says, Trifed and Dash to partner for implementing the Vandhan initiative in tribal clusters of all aspirational districts of India. Very, very easy questions. Because anywhere, अगर कहीं पे भी आपको aspirational district का नाम सुनाई देता है, then mark the answer as option D, नीति आयोग. Okay, option D, नीति आयोग is the correct answer. इसमें क्या होगा, जितने भी 39 ट्राइबल एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट हमारे देश के, वहां पे वंदन इनिशिएटिव, वंदन केंद्रास बनाए जाएंगे बाय द ट्राइफेड अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 29. इंडिया सफर्ड एक्सट्रीमली सिवियर साइक्लोनिक स्टॉर्म ऑफ द ईयर 2021 ताउते ड्यूरिंग द 13th मे टू दिस मे. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट वन ऑफ द स्टेट्स बीइंग अफेक्टेड बाय दिस. नाउ अब मैं बिल्कुल भी गलत नहीं होगा, मैं बिल्कुल सही होऊंगा. ओडिशा इज ऑन द ईस्टर्न साइड व्हाइल ताउते हिट द वेस्टर्न साइड. लास्ट टाइम जो है मैंने उल्टा बता दिया था. एंड हियर द करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन ए, उड़ीसा. उड़ीसा इज ऑन द ईस्टर्न कोस्ट ऑफ द कंट्री व्हाइल दीज स्टेट्स केरला गोवा गुजरात एंड कर्नाटका और ऑन द वेस्टर्न कोस्ट. ओके, आई होप दिस टाइम आई एम एब्सोल्युटली राइट. क्वेश्चन नंबर 30. विच मिनिस्ट्री और मिनिस्ट्रीज हैज डिसाइडेड टू सेट अप अ नेशनल कमीशन ऑन यूज ऑफ बायोमास इन कोल बेस्ड थर्मल पावर प्लांट्स. Now, under this mission, the biomass will be used in the coal-based thermal power plants and it will definitely reduce the carbon footprints. Carbon footprints ko reduce karega and also it will reduce the air pollution. Okay. And is mission ke baare mein isse zyada detail nahi aayi hai because abhi ye decide kiya gaya hai, approve hoga, jab launch hoga, then all the details will be provided by the ministry. And remember, the ministry is the Ministry of Power. Option A will be the correct answer and this ministry is headed by Mr. R.K. Singh. His Lok Sabha constituency is Ara. And now let's move ahead to question number 31. A startup has received the National Award 2021 for Technology Development Board for developing a commercial solution for conversion of CO2 to chemicals and fuels. You have to just name the startup. So remember guys, the name of the startup is Breathe Applied Sciences, which is in Bangalore. And it is located, it is incubated basically in the Jawaharlal Nehru Center for Advanced Scientific Research. Jawaharlal Nehru Center for Advanced Scientific Research, which is located in Bangalore. So option A will be the correct answer. And now question number 32. How much additional amount will be provided by central government to states for providing monetary assistance to 11.8 crore students under midday meal scheme? So remember, midday meal scheme ki baat chal rahi hai, toh thoda sa discuss kar lete hain. It was launched in the year 1995 as the National Program for Nutritional Support of Primary Education. But in the year 2004, it was rechristened as the midday meal scheme. And the basic objective of this scheme is to enhance the provide nutritional support to the school children ko nutritional support provide karana, thereby enhancing the enrollment, retention and attendance in the schools. And it was launched in 2004 by the Ministry of Education. Okay, the implementing ministry is the Ministry of Education, which is headed by Dr. Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank. Also remember that the एनर्जी का अमाउंट याद रख लो, इट इज 450 कैलोरी दैट शुड बी प्रोवाइडेड टू द स्टूडेंट्स इन द प्राइमरी स्कूल व्हाइल इट इज 700 कैलोरी फॉर द अपर प्राइमरी. एंड रिमेंबर इट इज अ सेंट्रली स्पॉन्सर्ड स्कीम विद अ फंडिंग रेशियो ऑफ 60:40 एंड ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास फर्स्ट टू एट के सभी स्टूडेंट्स को प्रोवाइड कराया जाता है, हु आर इन द गवर्नमेंट स्कूल, हु आर इन द गवर्नमेंट एडेड स्कूल, हु आर इन द मदरसाज और मकताब्स अंडर द सर्व शिक्षा अभियान. And for this, 1200 crore rupees has been provided as an additional amount by the central government to provide benefit to the 11.8 crore students. So option D, 1200 crores here will be the correct answer. And guys, the last question, question number 33, which section of Social Security Code 2020 provides for registration of unorganized workers, gig workers and platform workers? I hope you can easily answer this question now. Abhi recently humne padha tha ye. This is section 112 of the Social Security Code 2021, which provides for registration of unorganized workers, gig workers and the platform workers. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope you liked and enjoyed the session. And agar aapko ye session achha laga, so please share it with your friends and also hit the like button. And jitne bhi marks aaye hain, please write down in the comments. Kam ho ya zyada ho, usse koi farak nahi padta. Kyunki obviously, aisa koi nahi hai is duniya mein jisko sab kuch pata hai. So, अगर एक नंबर भी आया तो कमेंट करो, अगर एक नंबर भी आया तो कमेंट करो, सो दैट मुझे पता रहे कि मेरे स्टूडेंट जो है वो कितना पढ़ रहे हैं और कितना नहीं पढ़ रहे हैं. ओके, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग गाइज, मिलते हैं फ्राइडे के सेशन में. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.